This is a short tale about individuals who reject the ideas of comparative advantage and benefits from international trade. In the 1970s, Saudi Arabia ended up as a much wealthier country, in large part because the price of oil had gone up so much. The Saudis then set out and decided that they were going to grow more food. Now, upon reflection, Saudi Arabia is not naturally a low-cost country for growing most foodstuffs. The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia essentially has no lakes or rivers to speak of, and only a small part of the country gets enough natural rainfall to grow food. So for the most part, a decision to grow more food in Saudi Arabia meant a decision to subsidize water irrigation. In particular, the Saudis set out to grow more wheat. Over the years 1980 to 1992, they expanded their wheat production by a factor of 29. Saudi Arabia became the sixth largest wheat exporter in the world. They were even exporting wheat to the Soviet Union. How did such a dry country manage this? Well, they did it by massive subsidies to wheat growing and massive subsidies to water irrigation for wheat. So in Saudi Arabia, wheat production would cost around $500 a ton, when the market price was at the same time about $120 a ton. By growing their own wheat, the Saudis were making it almost five times more expensive. The Saudis also wasted a lot of water. To grow all this wheat, it required 300 billion cubic meters of water, most of it non-renewable. To put that in perspective, that's about equal to 6 years' flow of water of the Nile River into Egypt. Over time, however, the Saudis decided they simply couldn't afford all of these expenses. And in the year 2008, they decided to essentially give up on their wheat growing program with the goal that wheat production in Saudi Arabia would essentially be gone by 2016. It's already the case that there are plenty of wheat farms out there in Saudi Arabia where the equipment is sitting there unused, simply gathering rust. In this case, it would have been much cheaper for the Saudis to have relied on international trade from the very beginning. The Saudis made this mistake of starting to grow wheat in the first place, in part because they thought they could achieve national self-sufficiency, in part because they could show the population that they were somehow modernizing as a nation, in part because they simply got carried away from having so much surplus cash, and also because subsidizing wheat was a way of handing out goodies to a growing farm lobby. To read more on this episode, you can Google Saudi Arabia wheat, or see the discussion in my own book, An Economist Gets Lunch.